At Madroño Elementary, we were teaching the kids about soil moisture and how water percolates into aquifers.
We demonstrated that with the sponges and how it goes down to the groundwater aquifers. As soon as you went up to our table, all they saw was sponges. And they kind of looked, they were touching it and wanted to learn.
They came up, they were confused about what the sponges were for, and by the time they left, almost all of them understood a little bit about how groundwater works and how soil moisture works. It was really cool. It was definitely an awesome experience. I really enjoyed it, and I would even consider being an elementary school teacher for just because of that. That was really cool.
It was great to be hands-on too. We had a lot of props. Every group had something that the kids could actually do and feel. It was a big 3D map, and it had a wooden border, and there was little drains in the bottom of it so that we could make it rain and simulate the rain up in the mountains, and then it had the watersheds outlined.
So we went to Madroño Middle School in Thousand Oaks. So Carrie and I were working together on like the water cycle. Sadly, a few of the components didn't work, but we were able to adapt. So we made little clouds out of cotton balls and described three different cloud types. And regrettably, there weren't any clouds out in the sky at the moment, so we couldn't point those out to the kids. We also had plants and showed kids how the certain plants have much thinner leaves that they could transpirate a lot more, whereas succulents will not hold in all that water.
We presented to the kids different games that had to do with water management. So how much water crops use to grow, which crops use more water than others, and we had the kids compare them and put different foods in order from what uses more water to what uses the least amount of water, and we gave them a prize if they won. And I think they really enjoyed it because they kept coming back to a table even after they left. So I think they got really excited about it, and which is what we wanted to do. I think it's important when you're teaching kids to make it fun, incorporate bright colors and things they can touch, and then they can get excited about learning.
They got the visual, and they could also compete with each other and play the games that we had available to them, or even with the posters, they could lift up the little flaps that told you all the information. And it was really cool to see how excited they were about it. They seemed really motivated to learn more and to teach each other, so it felt good.
And our project is Take That Dam Down. So basically we created a dam out of Legos and foam, and we would let the water down and then there'd be sediment right behind the dam and it would show the buildup. And then we would take that dam down and then you'd see the sediment flow down and the students would learn about how dams are taken down.
Taught some kids about wave tanks and channel patterns.
Working with a flume, so basically just a model of a stream channel. So we were working to kind of show how sediment is transported with streams, how different water flow and different geographic conditions kind of influence stream patterns.
So because most of the field trips we've been on, our presenters have been really engaging, so that was one thing that we had to do with the children. Engage them in what we were talking about, and if we didn't, they kind of like lose their focus. So that's one thing I took from it.